Hello, everybody. This is Tom with 20th Century Rescue. Happy Saturday. I have here a bunch of glass I'm going to show you. It's not everything I have, plus some mid-century stuff, which we're probably going to start out with. That is not none of this stuff except for the Pierrepoint colognes is listed. So I'm selling all my glass, probably all of it. So it's just I've reached the limit to what I can have, really, and I just want to sort of start off and go a little more zen, if that's possible with me, as you can tell. Oh, okay, so there's a lamp. Let's start out with the lamp. That lamp is a mid-century on acid Hollywood Regency, and I have its twin right here, which needs to be, which needs to be rewired. It looks like a dog got to the plug here somehow. Look at this beauty. Now this is, this is going to be either you love it or you absolutely hate it. It looks like an alien with boobs. Hope I didn't ruin that with for the people who really like it, but it's lusterware purples with sort of a cream background, and purples, blues, gold. The base could use some cleaning and redoing. The plug, yeah, that was a Rottweiler, I think. So these are being sold as a pair. I don't care if they sell separately. The shade can go with it. It is listed as a no shade, but they are, in my mind, reminiscent of two things: a peacock here on the bottom and an air balloon on the top. They are stunners. They are pieces of art in and of themselves. I have no idea who made these, but these are probably my favorite lamps, and I am ready to let them go. There are no cracks, there are no chips, and these will be sent in double boxed. The first box will be a lamp box, which is will be cut down, I think, because these come off and shorten it. So here it is. So up to the socket, these are inches high and 32 inches high up to the top of the finial. So they will be packaged in a lamp box and then put inside a golf bag box. And so that means that there will be, if you want the shade, three separate shipments. Yikes. So these are listed as $600 for the pair, and I am not willing to negotiate. Somebody's already asked me, and I said no. I might split shipping with you. That's fine. So I'll pay for the shade and one lamp, and you pay for one lamp. You know, that can be $100 off. So there's that. These mid-century Hollywood Regency, Grandma took some acid. okay. So, and then there was light. So there you have that one. Let me put this down in a safe spot. So along with the mid-century connection here, just starting off that way. This is a macrame and ceramic mushroom bathroom towel holder. And it's easy to wash, actually. I just put it in some... Woolite. And the wood is all good. There's a paint spot here, which I can easily take off. Just, it's facing the wall, so I don't really care about it. And this lime green... And it is nice and tall. It's a showstopper in and of itself. It's not something somebody would expect to see these days, but this is going to be listed. It is not as yet listed. There you have that. And then, I don't know about you, but I love having clocks in the bathroom. And so this mid-century 60s, probably late 60s, early 70s, battery-operated clock. It's called Glance. So it's a Seth Thomas. 676. It's octagonal. There's a little bend to this hand, you can tell, and there is some marking on the top which can easily be taken care of if you care to. It works perfectly being battery operated. It never has steered me wrong when I wake up and groggily go into the bathroom and wonder what the heck time it is. It's a nice masculine clock. Good for a man cave, mid-century bathroom, entryway, kitchen. Hooks easily right here. And so that will be listed as well. It is not yet has not yet been listed. Gold, black, and brown. Wood grain, which is fake, by the way. Faux wood grain, I believe. I'm going to assume... But maybe I'm wrong. I don't know, because it is foiled on the back. Could very well be a piece of... I don't know. Anyway, there you have that. So what I'm going to start out with where the glass is concerned... ...is the Hawks Gravic Iris. Does have about 1 the rim. So it's got one. Let me count these because it has 9 total that I can see, but they're not all chips. There's some of them are flea bites. So there's 1 chip, 2 chip, as in a chip, flea bite 3. Flea bite 4, and by flea bite, this is, I don't know if you can see the edge of that, it's tiny. It's really a flea bite. I'm not lying, people. Where was I? Flea bite 5? 6? 7? Eight. Yeah, I counted 9 last night. So it is marked Gravic Hawks. And it is 8 or 10 inches. It's actually 9 inches from outside to outside. Therefore, inside to inside, it's 8. 8 inches inside to inside rim. So that's the Iris Gravic. I don't know. You know, there's not a lot out there. These are becoming increasingly rare. I don't know if I'll list it and buy it now on eBay or Etsy or do an eBay Auction. Don't know. I do not know. It's really hard to tell these days. You know, everybody poo-poos chips, and I belong to a fabulous group on Facebook, but you know, the more stupid people pack these things and crush them because they don't know how to pack, the less of this there's going to be. So, in my mind, you know, you don't want every, you know, each tooth chipped, but in my mind, the less there are out there, the more these are going to be valuable regardless of the chips. Because they just don't make this shit anymore. Oops, excuse me. They just don't make it anymore, period. So this is not going to be $20 because of the chips. I don't care. If it doesn't sell, it doesn't sell. Not to be pugnacious about it, but I think y'all know who know glass might disagree with me, but I'm older and I see futures very well. So start taking stock in some American brilliant. So that's the first one. The other one that's already been listed and showcased are the Pearpoint, and I have to do some research. I made a mistake in calling these Boston, I think they're Cambridge. This is gilded sterling silver, which I did finally polish with silver polish, and it came out beautifully. In research, what the research shows in the results is that I guess apparently 24 karat gold would not tarnish. I don't know if that's true if it's gilding, but lesser carats of gold such as 18 and 22 or 20, if there is a 20, I think it's 22, will tarnish. And when you take into consideration this had alcohol in it, it was cologne bottle, so smudges on the cover, but it comes off very easily with the silver polish. Now one has flea bite chips on the bottom and one does not. I think it's this one that does. Honestly, I can't really tell. I mean, I'm trying to be so particular sometimes, I bend over too far. Trying to, there's a flea bite chip right there on the bottom. It's hard to see, I know. But it's a beautiful pattern, either Boston or Cambridge. Apparently the notching is slightly different between the two. And let me show you their cousin. This is Boston, I believe. Picture. Well, geez, Tom, you have two of them right in front of you. Why don't you just look? Oh, yeah, I see. Okay, so the notching is different in that the, I don't know if you can see. Well, these are all horizontal notches, whereas the Boston has little horizontal and then vertical. I'm checking for chips. I don't think there are any. I do not believe there are any chips, and I don't see any markings. Deeply cut on the bottom, not huge deep. You know, there's a piece of paper in there. Plied handle, triple Ponties. Is that triple or double? That would look triple to me, sort of a diamond pattern. And there you have Pearpoint Boston with a, good Lord, the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30. 30 point star. Or hobnail, excuse me. It's a beautiful picture. I heard from somebody in doing research that you should not really hold these fully with the handle because they can apparently snap off. Got to remember these are over 100 years old. And God, to have survived that long without a chip makes me want to keep it. But I'm not going to. So there you have that. Okay. We have possible, you know what, I'm going to shut the window, look at the slides here and see if that makes it better. I'm not sure it will. Yeah, it actually might. Somebody suggested these might be Tuthill. They're unidentified, creamer and sugar, an etched flower. They're sparkly. They're very, very, very sparkly and large. There is a bit of a chip to the lip on this one. Looks like they hold about a cup each. Creamer seems to have less of a body of ability to hold volume, but one is, of course, dry volume, the other is wet volume. So got these as well. Okay. We're going to switch to McKee's Innovation Uranium Rose Bowl. This is very rare. And you know what that means. The etching is beautiful. For those of you who don't know, if I am correct, McKee was the first pressed glass company to etch glass, therefore the name Innovation. And get out the black light for you, make sure that you can see that it glows. All over. So this has not yet been listed. Nice clear pontal, tri-legged uranium glass etched and pressed rose bowl. It is 7.5 inches tall. The top outside to outside is 6.5 in diameter, and I think the total width is probably 7.5 as well. Well, that doesn't make sense. Yeah, 6.5 and 7.5 at its widest point. And weighs, geez, probably 4 pounds, maybe. So this will be listed as well. All right, we do have some smaller things here and three large bowls. Let's just continue with the bowls. This is Hawks. It's an incredible bowl. Notice the notch here, the V. It's It's hard to tell sometimes if there's a chip or if it's purposeful, because that notch is so particularly shaped the same way on every single one. So that's not a chip. I don't know if I'm showing you the correct. See, there's a little curve in the bottom of each V. That starburst is a fantastic design. So this is unidentified. Somebody might have said something, let me see, as to whether or not it might be a specific pattern or not, or somewhat similar to it. Let me see. Oh, the creamer might be Libby as well. Tuthill or Libby. Tuthill Wild Rose or Libby. I don't know. I don't have the information on any comments on this from my group. But that is number one. My favorite is this that is attributed possibly to Tuthill. This is probably what would be called cut to pieces. It's an incredible, incredible, incredible bowl. The edge is unusual. It's about 10 inches, I believe. It's just incredible. This thing is just incredible. No markings that I can tell. Very little space left uncut. My favorite, favorite piece. Besides the colognes. I do not see any chips. Nope. Oh. Yep, found one. Right here. So, I can't imagine somebody doing this. The artistry, the talent, the patience, the non-shaky hands. It's just incredible. And for your edification, from outside to outside, it is 9 3/4 inches, and it stands at its highest point. It looks like 2 3/4 inches tall at its highest point. And this is a showstopper. And this will be listed probably tomorrow after I do my taxes. Ugh, I hate taxes. And so, two more pieces here. Let me top off my coffee and my... This is my favorite coffee pot I've ever had. I bought this to sell and tested it out. I have never had such a hot cup of coffee in my life. It works beautifully. So, it's a percolator, obviously. I had a early 1900s, beautiful. You know what? If I can grab it. No, it's all the way up there. Shoot. You know what? Be right back. Which reminds me, this will be for sale. I bought this years ago off of eBay. I have used it for 10 years. I do not know how to get the inside clean. It's enamel. It does, through my use, I don't see any wear. Well, obviously, it's got wear here, but a very short universal number 1308. The inside looks like it's been in a coal mine for 10 years, which it has. It's been making coffee. It does a really nice job. I had no issue with it. But the heat retention is not there in this. If you have a warmer, that's fine. You know, it would be easy just to put one of those metal grids things on the stovetop and keep it warm without burning it. And it doesn't, I don't know. If somebody has any suggestions as to what to do, I've heard people say they put bleach in here, and I don't want to do that. I don't want to poison my customers. But if it won't poison my customers, I'll do it. But this is a beauty. And this came from, all the woman knew about it was this was her grandmother's, and it was a wedding gift. It had never been used, unless she used bleach on it, but it looked like it had never been used. This thing, I can't remember who made it, and it's hot, full of coffee, and I don't want to turn it upside down at the moment to look, but I, aluminum, it's pretty thick gauge aluminum, well, maybe not. An eighth of an inch thick. Is that really an eighth of an inch? Anyway, it's fantastic. So if you see one like that, pick it up. All right. We have another bowl, oblong bowl, that is attributed, not definitively, possibly Sinclair. And this is another unusual edge. It's got fuchsia flowers on it, on here, perhaps a daisy here, with like a butterfly vesicus four. And the very unusual edge. Thick, very thick, quarter inch. Quarter inch? Yeah. Well, might be closer to half an inch. Let me get my facts straight before I lie to people. Well, it's 3/8 of an inch. So yeah. It doesn't come across as being overtly heavy either, but the design is just incredible. There are no markings as far as I can tell. There are no markings. Beautiful all the way around. If there's a chip, I don't see it, and if there's a flea bite, and I don't see it, I'm not taking the blame because I don't. Nope, this appears to be in pretty excellent condition. So, the quality is beautiful, the edge is beautiful, the workmanship is beautiful, everything. Last piece, for this week anyway. This is Elmira's number 22. A small plate. Does have chips. Well, one. think one ship. Not particularly exciting, but at least it's identified. So it does have one. Interesting. Okay. You notice the point here, point here, and point here towards each shape of a triangular portion of the star. This is a bread plate. Too big for a bread plate? I don't know. Who knows? Maybe it had a cover as well. I don't remember. But this is be for sale. That is all the glass that I'm going to show today. I've got a lot of listing to do. And not everything will be listed today or this weekend, probably. As, you know, everybody's got other stuff to do as well. So if you have any questions, DM me or post a comment in the comment section. If you have any ideas to identification, post in the comments. Please, please, please like. I am trying to grow this channel. As you know, I started out pretty weekly, and as time went along, it took a dive. So I am not really here for entertainment purposes. I am here for the product that I'm selling. So it's rather straightforward, showcasing the objects, not Tom. Though I have a great personality, I can be somewhat grumpy sometimes. But please like and share and help grow my channel. And you have a great rest of your Saturday. Bye-bye.